Outgoing President Rodrigo Duterte expressing hope the next administration will continue his projects, which he said have made the Filipino public happy. This as the chief executive led the turnover of residential units to select uniformed workers in Davao City on Wednesday, which was among the additional benefits he gave them during his term. Duterte said it is now up to his allies in the Senate, Senators Bongo and J.V. Ejercito, to continue pushing for his programs.
So, I hope that the program,
nandito man si Senator Dalawa, sana sila na ang mag-udyok sa administrasyon na hindi kalimutan yung mga proyekto na umpisaan na napakaganda. I hope that the next administration will also continue the things that would make our people happy.
Meanwhile, at least two cabinet members of outgoing Philippine President Duterte to serve in the incoming Marcos administration. Former Cabinet Secretary Carlo Nograles is renominated as the chair of the Civil Service Commission. His previous nomination to the post was bypassed by the Commission on Appointments. Outgoing Labor Secretary Sylvester Belli III is tapped as the new chair of the Manila Economic and Cultural Office in Taiwan. A former Deputy Director General of the National Police, Ricardo De Leon, was earlier named as the new chief of the National Intelligence Coordinating Agency. A prelude to a full-blown digital martial law. That's how human rights group Karapatan describes the order of the Philippine government to block several websites with alleged links to communists. It says the move affirms concerns raised by several groups against the anti-terrorism law are legitimate. Karapatan also calls the order a blatant violation of constitutional and international human rights standards. The National Telecommunications Commission, or NTC, earlier blocked several websites for their alleged links to rebels. They include sites of media outlets and progressive groups. The move was done upon the request of National Security Advisor Hermógenes Esperon.
For former Supreme Court spokesperson and criminal law professor Theodore Te, the NTC order may be considered a form of prior restraint when it comes to news providers and a violation of freedom of expression. But Esperon insists there's no violation of press freedom whatsoever.
There will always be our own concern for press freedom because that is something that is dear to us. But there is also our responsibility for correct information and our aversion for misinformation. Okay lang yung criticism, pero they connect that to towards recruitment of people that may join the armed group, which is the NPA. Iba na ang takbo.
Retired Supreme Court Senior Associate Justice Antonio Capio, one of the petitioners who questioned the anti-terrorism law before the High Court, also speaking out against the move. He says most organizations included in Secretary Esperon's list were not even designated as terrorists by the Anti-Terrorism Council.
The ATC, the Anti-Terrorism Council, did not recommend anything against these websites, no? Mm. Wala. Ito, galing lang ito sa National Security Council. Pinadala ng letter yung NTC na i-block itong mga websites na ito. So, actually, it's just the action of National Security Council and the NTC. So, yun ang ablahin ngayon ng mga website na anong kasalanan namin? Wala naman kayong court order. At saka wala kayong power to block the website.
For Senator Panfilo Lacson, the blocking of the websites is justified if they are being used to finance the Communist Party of the Philippines, which has been labeled as a terrorist group by the government. Lacson is one of the principal sponsors of the Anti-Terrorism Act of 2020.
The Philippine poll body junks a bid to block the substitution of a controversial former election official as a party list representative. The Duterte Youth Party List group filed a case last week opposing Rowena Guanzon's substitution as a nominee of the P3 PWD party list. The oppositors argued the substitution filed by Guanzon this month was done past the November deadline. But the Election Commission explains its resolution, which set the November deadline, does not cover events that take place after the May 9th elections. The poll body also notes it allows substitutions for Duterte youth nominees themselves after the 2019 midterm polls. Guanzon took her oath Thursday as Congresswoman-elect. She said her oath was administered by an appellate court judge who used to work for her father.